Go.
Good evening. Welcome to Shutesbury Community Church this evening. We have a special service tonight. During the past 18 months, it's been a difficult time for everyone as we've had to isolate ourselves from one another, distance ourselves from others when we did venture out even for something as mundane as going grocery shopping, and hide ourselves behind masks that prevented us from freely sharing our emotions with one another. For those who have lost loved ones during this time, it has been especially difficult because the normal process of grieving has been interrupted by the precautions that were required by the coronavirus, especially the gathering of loved ones during this time to say goodbye to celebrate the life of the people that they love. So everyone here tonight, I believe, has experienced this or knows someone who has experienced it. So we're gathering now to grieve our losses together, to share our experiences, our heartaches with one another, and to seek support from our church family and our friends. We'll share scripture tonight because God knows that we are experiencing this, and He has provided solace in His holy word. We will sing hymns that speak of our losses and that will help us release the emotions that have grown up in us over this time and may be trapped within us. And we will pray prayers to seek God's help and the healing work of the Holy Spirit tonight as we give our burdens and pain over to our Lord and ask Him to give us His strength and comfort. And finally, we will speak aloud the names of the loved ones that we have lost. And as their names are spoken in the church, those their loved ones who are here tonight will come and light a candle for them in their memory. And as a family, I pray that we will hold each other up in our love and the love of Jesus. So let us pray. Heavenly Father, Holy Lord Jesus, our Savior, we thank You that You are a loving and faithful God, that You are always present in our lives, and that You provide to us the strength that we fail to have in ourselves, that You comfort us in times of pain, in times of fear, in times when things seem bleak, as they certainly did during this time of coronavirus. We thank You, Lord, that we are now coming out of it and that things are freeing up and becoming easier. And we pray, Lord, that You will continue to be there for us and that You will help us. Tonight, as we lift up the names of our loved ones, Lord, we pray that You will provide a comforting hand. We pray that You will provide Your strengthening arm to us. We are so grateful for what our Savior did to assure us of life everlasting in the presence of God. We pray all these things in the holy name of our Savior Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Now I will invite you to sing the song, In the Garden.
Thank you.
Psalm 23 in the King James Version, and I invite you, if you know it, to speak it with me. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He lead me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Now we will sing, "The Lord is my shepherd." Wanting only the best for us. We're going to look tonight at Psalm 103, a few of the passages from that psalm. And verses 13 and 14 say, as a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. For he knows how we are formed. He remembers that we are dust. Our mortal life here is momentary. Here today and gone tomorrow, the Bible teaches us. This is the way of things. So the psalm says in the next two verses, it says, the life of mortals is like grass. They flourish like a flower of the field. The wind blows over it, and it is gone, and its place remembers it no more. But our life on earth is not the end of life for any of us. The Bible tells us again and again in its pages that eternal life awaits us when we pass from this place. And we can find joy in knowing that our Lord is gracious and his promises that he gives us, he keeps. He promises those who love and revere him that his love will be eternally present with them. The next two verses of this psalm assure us of this. They say, but from everlasting to everlasting, the Lord's love is with those who fear him and his righteousness with their children's children, with those who keep his covenant and remember to obey his precepts. Jesus, our Savior, who died on the cross to ensure our eternal salvation, made this promise more personal for us individually, each one of us. He told his disciples, and through his word, he assures us each time we read it, that at the end of this mortal life that we live here will be a heavenly home waiting for us that is prepared just for us. That's how great God's love is for us. In John 14, 1 to 3, Jesus says, do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. So as we grieve the passing of our loved ones, let's also celebrate in the knowledge that Jesus Christ has gone ahead and has prepared a place for all of those that believe in him, that through his sacrifice on the cross, he has made it possible for each one of us to choose him and to choose eternity in the presence of God the Father. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we are so grateful for the sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for us, that we might be assured of eternal life with you. When we think of the pain and the agony that he went through, we have greater understanding of just what this means, what this means to us. And Lord, we are just so grateful. We are thankful tonight that we're able to come together with the assurance of Christ's love and share our grieving for those whom we've all lost. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. And now we have a special song from Veronica and Adrian called On Eagle's Wings.
Thank you.
as I read their names and the pictures appear on the screen on the TV. As your loved one's name is spoken, please come forward. Light a candle, please reach to the back so that no one gets burned by ones in the front as they're reaching beyond. And as you pass, go back to your seat, Corrine has made some special lattice decorations that are quite beautiful. Feel free to take one as a remembrance of tonight. Let us pray. Holy, holy God, we are so blessed to have you. And we were so blessed to have the people in our lives that we are celebrating and honoring tonight. Lord, you have just filled our lives with blessings. And we miss them now. But we treasure what they gave to us and the relationship that we had with each one of them. And we're so thankful to you for allowing us to have that time, to have that relationship, to have the joy and the love that we shared with each of these people. Lord, they'll never be replaced because they can't be. But we have the joy of knowing that we may see them again when our life here is done. And that is such a joy to know. Thank you, Lord, for the love you give us and the love that you give us to share with one another. We pray in Jesus' name. Gertrude Britton. Joan C. Roy put it. James put it, victim of COVID. Michelle Kiki Ledger. Thank you. Daryl Tucker Haley. Teresa Bienkowski. Kelvin James. Theodore Rappetet Cumberbatch. Thank you. there's anyone else here tonight who has lost a loved one and would like to come forward and light a candle, you're welcome to do so now. If you'd like to say the name of your loved one, you're welcome to do that too.
Somebody I know, Lena Topolsky, someone from town.
To light one more for someone who is dearly loved by a number of the people in this room. But I'm going to do it not anonymously for me, because I'm doing it without saying his name. Assures us of God's unending love, even in the midst of trial and tribulation. It says, the faithful love of the Lord never ends. His mercies never cease. Great is his faithfulness. His mercies begin afresh each morning. I say to myself, the Lord is my inheritance. Therefore, I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who depend on him, to those who search for him. So it is good to wait quietly for salvation from the Lord. For no one is abandoned by the Lord forever. Though he brings grief, he also shows compassion because of the greatness of his unfailing love. For he does not enjoy hurting people or causing them sorrow. Tonight, we have all felt the sorrow and the hurt and the pain of saying goodbye to loved ones that we have lost in these recent months. COVID-19 was such a terrible time, and I pray to God that we're behind it, that it's behind us, and we're beyond it, that we can go on in a more normal life. But we do go on. The Bible doesn't tell us a lot about what heaven is like. There's very little in the Bible about heaven. And what it does say is very possibly metaphor. And so we cannot necessarily literally take the description in the Bible of what everlasting life is really like and depend on it. But we can be assured that what our loved ones who are today in heaven have found, and what we ourselves will experience when we get there, is a joy greater than we have ever known. So I leave you tonight with these reassuring words from Revelation 7, 16 to 17. It says, "Never again will they hunger. Never again will they thirst. The sun will not beat down on them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd. He will lead them to the springs of living water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." Let's sing "How Great Thou Art," and I would invite you to stand. I want to thank you all for coming tonight. And I know how difficult it is to do something like this. I have three loved ones there, myself, my brother, my only sibling, my favorite cousin, and my best friend, fellow singer and praise brothers. And so I know how difficult this is. But I also know how great our God is. He is so great. And he will bring us all through this. And he will give us strength, and he will give us the comfort that we need. And he will provide whatever it is that we need in the coming months to come through this stronger, better, more faithful, and more loving with the love of Jesus. And so as you go tonight, please come forward and take one of these. You know, it was kind of emotional and difficult to think to grab one, but they're absolutely beautiful. Corinne made them, and they'll be a nice keepsake. As you go home tonight, hold your loved one in your heart and revere your God, for he has such a future planned for each one of us. Yes. The Lord bless you and keep you. Yes. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord turn his face to you and give you peace. May you go in peace tonight, carrying the love of Jesus and sharing him and sharing his love with all that you need. Amen.
And one last time, Jesus Christ, thank you and praise you. And thank you for sending us to study. You're good guy. You're good to get to me. I love you, brother.
Good night, Al.
Finish.